And we have Chill Out Scooby-Doo, but that was from 2007, so it's probably
I've seen that.
Yeah, how was it?
From what I remember, it was just okay.
Oh. It was just okay. Oh, remember years and years ago when they started kind of redoing the Scooby-Doo movies? You had Scooby-Doo and Zombie Island, which was the best.
That was a good one.
Zombie Island was fucking was great, yeah.
Scooby-Doo and Zombie Island was great. You had Scooby-Doo and the Witch's Ghost. The Witch's Ghost, that was pretty good. You had Scooby-Doo meets the aliens or whatever it was.
That's the one.
Was it Cyber Trail or something? Cyber.
Yeah, there was that. There was also. Yeah, yeah.
There was when they go to Australia and there's the vampire like band.
Yeah, that was actually part of Witch's Ghost. They're the Hex Girls.
Those are the
name of the band.
Girls. No, so there's another Scooby-Doo movie where they go to Australia, and there's like this rock band that's playing, but then a vampire, like when he's in like the bat kind of form, comes up and they find out it's just an illusion, but there's an actual vampire.
I had no idea about
it. Came out a few years after. So the Witch's Ghost and the zombie one came out in the beginning of those series of movies. The one I'm talking about is a little bit like maybe 8 years after that.
And the Curse of the Australian Vampire Band. So, we're talking about Scooby-Doo and the Legend of the Vampire?
Yeah, so that's when they go to Australia.
Yeah, that's what I put in. That's what I put into Google, Scooby-Doo and the Curse of the Australian Vampire Band. And there it is.
Made aware.
You just gotta know what to search for.
The Bob Chipman celebrated Captain Marvel for beating out the 1 billion score as though it's a shock. And it's like, The film that was between the two biggest fucking movies ever.
Yeah, shocker.
Apparently that is, you know, surprising. But Joker, a movie that's disconnected from the DCEU, made by a director with, like, no expectation of creating something amazing. I mean, you know, I know a lot of people like the Hangover movies. I'm pretty sure I do as well, but nobody was expecting that.
How would you not know if you like them or not?
If you like what or not.
Because I'm pretty sure I do too.
Did I say that?
To the Hangover movies. Yeah.
Hangover. Maybe, I saw the first one. It was
I had a brain fart because I was like, I know I like the first one. I can't remember what I think of the rest of them. So
the second one is where they're in Thailand and he gets the tattoo on his face. The one guy gets his finger chopped off.
Oh my God.
You don't remember that one? Stu's getting married?
Maybe I didn't see it.
You don't remember this one? Oh, and yeah, they have to get the monkey that is a drug dealer.
Yeah, I don't think I saw it.
Oh, yeah, it's all coming together. Yes. No.
And then the third one is where John Goodman is in it. And so he's the one that I guess Mr. Chow stole all of his gold. So they have to go get the rest of the gold from Mr. Chow's old house. And then you find out that the gold was actually the gold that John Goodman already had. So they ended up stealing the other half of his gold. And then Alan gets married.
What do you think? You sound like you remember them. How good were they, do you think? What would you say?
Alan. Oh, Alan. I'm glad he was able to get married.
Yeah, he gets married to what's her name? Oh my God,
is it Heather Ms. Graham?
McCarthy. Yeah. McCarthy or something.
Melissa McCarthy?
Yes, he gets married to her.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, Senator McCarthy.
Yeah.
Hey, which of the Hex Girls was your favorite? Which one was Wolf? Wolf.
He's abandoned the podcast.
Fuck. All right. Mahler, which of the Hex Girls would you bone?
Why wouldn't you ask
all of them
female guests
the answer
of this question?
All of
sir.
Them is obviously the answer. All right. We'll start from the top. Jay Longbone, which of the Hex Girls would you bone first?
Nigga, I ain't watched that shit.
Oh, man.
You don't like Scooby-Doo?
No. All right. I watched the original show when I was a kid. I didn't get into all the spin-off stuff and the newer stuff. I don't know why.
Well, this stuff came out in like the early 2000s, right? I don't know, Rags, you just Googled it. What years did those come out?
Well, let me check the Scoobypedia.
So like they've been in multiple iterations then, because I seem to have got like a game version here. And cartoon version.
Yeah, so there's the cyberspace one. So that's the one where they go through different like levels of cyberspace through the video game, and because they're at a carnival.
I shouldn't put Google on screen. Who knows what's going to come up? I better be careful.
they appeared in Scooby-Doo and the Witch's Ghost. They were in Scooby-Doo and the Legend of the Vampire. They were also in What's New Scooby-Doo, and they made some appearances here.
Yeah, it's because they were so popular.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Did you watch the ones where it was just Scooby, Shaggy, and Scrappy?
The old ones.
Well, they had the Boo Brothers, and they had the one where they were teaching like the monsters. So all the like scary monsters from movies.
Yeah,
they all had daughters.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, the problem is that Scrappy's a little fucking cunt, and it was really hard for even like a child me
they made
to put
him
up
a,
with Scrappy.
They made him
bullshit.
A villain in the movie, didn't they? Because they were like, people hate but Scrappy,
they did.
Dude.
They did. Absolutely, because Scrappy's a little asshole.
I don't know. I like Scrappy.
You could have a lake of acid, and Scrappy would be like, "I'm gonna go beat the fucking acid up."
Then it's so cute because then Shaggy just picks him up because he's so little, and he's like trying to punch him, and his like hands are moving, his little legs are moving, but he can't like touch anything because he's getting held up. It's so cute.
Can't you just appreciate the spirit of Imrags?
The spirit of Scrappy. Mm-hmm. I wish he was just a spirit.
Wow.
Scrappy's the kind of nigga who'll slap your girl on the ass in the club.
And then be like,
yeah,
it's all good. It's all good.
Girl's ass in the club. That is typical Scrappy.
Scrappy behavior.
Typical Scrappy. Then you just punt him out the front door because he's a small thing.
Like,
but
they
then
did
he
in
figures
the movie.
Out how to get back in because he's small and he's nifty.
Yeah. So, what are we thinking? What are we thinking, Anna? Are we thinking Thorn, Dusk, or Luna? Who's going first?
For what?
For who? Okay. Which of the three members of the Hex Girls, who'd you bone first?
None, because they're not men.
Oh my god.
That's so sexist.
That, you're not being a trans ally.
I'm okay. Sorry. I'm not all attracted right. to women.
Matt Mahler.
I'm going for the black hair, personally.
Discussion.
I'm gonna base it on hair pretty much. I like the black hair.
Who's got black hair?
The middle one?
Thorn? No, it's like dark red.
It's
black, but it has like a red highlight to it.
Right. Yeah, it's like whenever it looks black, but whenever the sunlight hits it, you can tell like, oh, that's really dark red. It's like blood red.
Well, that's a trick that they used in animation, is so that if your character has like a, you know, black hair, like even like a black mask, they put like a highlight on it. So that way you can see the character against the background, especially when the backgrounds are going to be night. So that's why she has the red.
Oh, yeah. But, well, the two of them have the red then, because there was Orange Blossom. Luna is her name. The keyboarder person lady. Mm-hmm. Keyboard person. I don't want to say keyboardman. That's mm-hmm. you know, it's
very rude.
The keyboardist. But.
The keyboardist, the pianist, yes. So, movie Bob. Now that we've settled the
Well, wait, what was your choice, Rags? What was your choice?
Oh, I'm absolutely fucking Thorn first.
All right, yeah, okay. I'm glad that was important. Bob, you may continue now.
Of human history, pulling a big number opening uncontested in early fall is some kind of miraculous, unexpected victory for the film and its fans against the overwhelming adversary of marginally divided reviews from professional critics and...
It's pretty underselling it a little with how this movie was covered by the media.
Yeah, it was down to like 50-something... originally.
Not to mention just the headlines.
They were like trying to kill that movie before it even came out, saying, oh, don't go to the theater. You're going to get shot if you go to a theater and watch this movie.
Yeah, we covered Jenny Nichols, and she was like, I didn't go to a normal theater. I went to a drive-in theater to improve my survival odds.
Okay,
yeah.
You know what? I actually don't believe her on that because she and I...
Dude, you don't?
Here's the thing, Rags. She and I live relatively close together, and me and my friend Sav, we like to go to drive-ins, but hey, guess what? There's none down here. And I was like, huh, she went to go see Joker. Let me go through and find all the drive-ins around me and what days they were out. Her evidence, it's not lining up. It's not.
It's not.
Nope.
Yeah, there was a good chance she made it up on the spot to be like, look how, like, I did that as evidence of, like, how, like, quick, I guess. And then when she was called out how much it doesn't make sense, she was just like,
No, like, oh, what are you going to do?
he's levitating marshmallows.
Is that...
Are those marshmallows or chiclets?
I thought they were sugar cubes.
Yeah, I thought they were cubes for a second there.
Are they not? I can't tell very well in this picture.
Oh, it's perfect.
You like my robe? It's based off of...
He's looking pretty good there in terms of, like, he's lost a lot of weight. Good stuff, Bob. he wears the shades under the mask, I guess.
Do you think it's hard to fit them under there?
I think so.
Probably.
So, what is Cinema Roberto said so far?
Oh, you missed him saying that it was no shock this movie did well because it's a part of a big franchise. So why is everyone raving about that?
Why is everyone raving about the fact that it did well?
Because we know it'll piss off people like you, Bob.
We'll get Wolf's take on this, right? Get ready, Wolf.
So, Joker made a bunch of money at the box office over the weekend, which is being treated as a surprise for purposes of further marketing, as though the idea that a movie about probably the second most popular character in one of the most popular franchises in the most popular movie genre on the planet for like the last decade of human history, pulling a big number opening uncontested in early fall, is some kind of miraculous, unexpected victory for the film and its fans against the overwhelming adversary of marginally...
Go ahead.
Okay, Bob, let me try to explain this to you in a way that your small mind can possibly understand. It is a shock that a movie that is not attached to the DCEU as it currently stands, a movie made by the guy who's known for making the Hangover films, and a movie that is rated R, has done this well. That's why it's a surprise. Not because it's a superhero movie, but because it's completely detached from the current superhero movies made by a guy who really, no one would ever think he'd make a good superhero movie. And it's rated R, and it broke the record for a highest rated.
Broke a lot of records, which is pretty much the most objective evidence we can have in terms of it doing better than expected. It's beating out records.
I'm just glad it did well.
I wasn't surprised at all by it. I watched the trailer and I was like, this is going to be a really good movie. It's probably going to make a lot of money.
I can't say I was
expecting it to do okay because it wasn't attached to anything and it was just this movie about a character that they're calling Joker, and it's like I didn't know how good it was gonna be. Just to support that, by the way, do you hear that he said the second most popular character in the franchise? He's referring to Batman being more popular. So how does he explain Justice League? I will keep coming back to that.
I mean, isn't, like, the whole appeal of The Dark Knight being the Joker? Like, no one talks about Batman in that movie.
It's because even Christian Bale has regrets about his portrayal of Batman in that movie. It's just, like, Batman's fine in that movie. And that's kind of almost what you could call an issue. It's like he's not... Maybe it's because a lot of people talk about whether or not it's Batman or Bruce Wayne that's boring, or both, or not boring but not interesting enough. I don't know if it's just hard to be interesting when you're acting alongside someone like Heath Ledger as Joker. Can be tough.
Well, that one dude did it in A Knight's Tale.
Yeah.
Why would you
Rufus Swole? That's actually my
favorite.
He's
not the Joker in that. He's a completely different character.
Listen.
That's a great movie.
That's the point. You guys chat back me up. A Knight's Tale?
It's a good film, but what are you talking about?
Well, you're like, it's hard to... You were like, hey, it's hard to stand out when you're next to Heath Ledger. But I was like, oh yeah, well, what about the guy?
I specified Heath Ledger's Joker, you disingenuous Joker. Person.
No, Heath Ledger, he played kind of a Joker character. He told some jokes in that.
Oh, okay.
He was kind of a Joker in that.
Rags, you're not appreciating...
You're
not appreciating Stay Puft Bob.
On Heinrich von Lichtenstein.
Ulrich von Lichtenstein.
His head fits so perfectly onto that body.
Wait, what's the photo? Oh, it's Bob's face on it.
It looks exactly like him.
We're becoming the thing that we swore to destroy.
Does he have dimples, or is that just his cheekbones?
I don't. We that's a forever. We don't know. My theory was that he had a horrible accident where his face was stretched open, and the surgery couldn't fix it all.
Do you think his head's like a pufferfish, and like when he's like not angry, his face like sucks in on itself?
Oh, it could be.
I think it's weird that someone who's so large has cheekbones like that.
That's the thing. I don't know what's going on there.
Why I think they're dimples. Because when you get older, like with your dimples, I notice that, especially on men, is they kind of become wrinkles that are just lines in your cheeks like that. Like, those what's the guy from Game of Thrones that, Catelyn's brother?
Heath Ledger.
No. Mahler, Game of Thrones, Catelyn's brother.
I know this one. The dude who was useless and everything?
Yeah, Edmure? The one that...
Edmure yes, Tully? Edmure.
So he, you know, he's got the lines on his face, on his cheeks, and all his. I realized I'm like, okay, so he had dimples, and that's the wrinkles from his dimples. So that's kind of like Movie Bob here. So I think he just has dimples.
Yeah, as Nathan T just highlighted, he's both fat and gaunt. It's very odd.
He is font.
One of his dimples could pass as a swimming pool.
No, don't say that just because he probably sweats a lot. why would you even suggest that? I can't believe you would say that on national television.
Did victory
look,
for the...
No one assumed that until you said something.
Global saturation.
If you're going to say that, you have to put on the accent. Do it.
Crass. No, yeah. Crass. Just,
complete
I'm too...
global saturation.
Crass.
Oh,
Resident Evil 5 is terrible. But
it's so great in how terrible it is.
It kind of is. It really. It's a specialism.
Okay.
Hey. Mm-hmm. Let's see what he has to say about Joker.
Okay. Let's do it.
I'm glad that it made a lot of money.
As am I. The fucking one crumb of hope we got in this terrible year of movies.
Chris,
the one crumb of hope.
Chris.
It made a lot of money, Chris.
Ouroboros, Joker, Chris.
Why do people Ouroboros. Keep asking me, like, what is the Hex Girl question? I don't know what
you
that means.
You have to answer which one of those.
All right, Rex, ask it up. Do it.
All right, I'm glad that you're here again, Wolf. It's good. We're glad to have you back. So, are you familiar with the Hex Girls?
No.
Well, let me tell you. So, are you familiar with Scooby-Doo and the Witch's Ghost?
No.
You're like Jay. You haven't seen anything. You haven't seen any real films. You haven't seen any real films.
I haven't seen a Scooby-Doo movie since I was like 10.
What?
Scooby-Doo. And the Witch's Ghost came out way back in like 2000, something like that, long tisms ago. Now there was a band of vampire ladies, but they weren't really vampires, but they thought they were vampires.
They're witches.
They're called the Hex Girl. They're
witch.
Wiccans. You're right.
Mm-hmm.
So Willow's a part of this group then.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Willow.
She doesn't play a musical instrument in the band. There's only three girls.
But this one time at band camp, she did.
Well, Thorn, Dusk, and Luna.
That's some deep referencing we've just done there. I like it.
I know. Yeah.
I'll get you a picture of the Hex Girls here, and you can tell me which one you want to bone first.
Okay. Why did you say that in like a more mischievous voice? Which one you want to bone first?
Why would you mischievously...
Fucking greasy as hell.
I know, right?
There are three...
Tell me which one you'd bone, Chris.
Rockstar ladies pretending to be witches. And you're like, all right, it's so greasy, you want to bone them. All right, so those are the Hex Girls.
Definitely not the one on the left. She looks like she has autism.
I know, she's like Buttercup from the... Well, it's a bad analogy.
Jesus, Rags, stay away from that comparison.
I gotta go with a hard middle. The middle.
Hard
the
middle?
Best.
Hard for the middle? I agree. I think the chicken, that's Thorn, right?
Oh my god, she has the edgiest name I think I've heard.
Yeah.
Ever.
Thorn.
But what are the other two names again?
Dusk and Luna.
I'm guessing Dusk is the retard?
Dusk is the retard?
The one on the left.
Oh my goodness. I can't say that. So Luna is the pianist.
Whoa, dude.
Get it out of your system. Get it out of your system.
Come around seeing that.
Luna's on the right. That's Luna. Okay. Dusk is on the left because she's often left in the
dust.
I don't know. Dusk. She bites the dusk whenever all the boys come around because they're like,
"How did
yeah,
we get on this born. Exactly? I don't know.
We were talking about Scrappy.
Rags is a big fan of Scooby-Doo. It's fine.
I don't actually know how we got to talking about this.
Should we let Bob make another point? I'm curious where he's going to go with this, okay?
He had no points.
Fine. He already made one that was really wrong. He's 1-1. 0-1. The maths.
Like, it depends. I don't know. Critic. This one's like, meh. This one's a, like, it's like a non-point, sort of. Like, I guess some people were really surprised.
He's doing the thing where he's like, you shouldn't even be shocked by this. And it's like, anyone could be shocked for any fucking reason. There's plenty of reason to be shocked by this.
I'm not sure.
And some scattering overhyping of random concern trolling in the national media.
I'm deflated! A fitting end for you, Joker.
Which Joker's become...
Oh, that's wonderful editing.
Diabeto.
Joker's become Diabeto.
He's become Diabeto.
Hey, it means that he knows his shit. He's referencing the old stuff.
That's true.
People are telling me to adjust my settings so that way the microphone only picks up me in Discord. I don't know how to do that, though.
Whatever you need to do might be something that ends up being a little bit too complicated for now. Like, whatever you've been doing from now is working, so...
Could you hear it this last time?
I don't think so, but if we do, we'll probably let you know.
Okay, because I just put my hands over the microphone.
Alright, then.
Turned bizarrely
hold on.
Damn it.
Anna, you're familiar with this Scooby-Doo movie then. Is this person in the chat telling the truth when they say fun fact, Dusk tried to hook up with the dog?
What dog? Scooby-Doo?
No, the other dog in the show.
There are other dogs. There's Scrappy-Doo.
I was going to say, there is
the Labrador from
Fred. And then
Fred's
one of them
hot.
Is like petting Scooby, but they don't try to hook up with him unless it happens in the one where Scooby gets turned into a man. But
oh my goodness, I have to look up Scooby-Doo as a human. Oh my god.
Don't quote me on that. I'd have to go back and watch them, but the reason why these are also fresh in my memory is because my stepdaughter has been watching, you know, crappy TV show, so I'm like, no, you're gonna get some culture. So I got all of the TV.
Yeah, hence me saying,
oh my god.
Oh my
god. He looks like a Jewish penis.
He looks like a what?
A Jewish penis.
Oh.
Oh my goodness.
I just spit out my juice all over my
Oh, why? You're the one who brought it up. Didn't you already have a mental image in your head?
That's a nose right there. He could drive that through walls.
Oh my goodness. He could sniff a shekel 10 miles away.
I can almost feel Ben Shapiro blushing.
To be fair, EFAP, we are friends of all of the Jewish people.
Including
and I
Scooby-Doo.
All of these nasty, terrible jokes that they're telling about. This is Scooby-Doo. His ethnicity is dog. I don't know what you want.
Why is he? They gave him a brown T-shirt, I guess.
Well, yeah.
To match.
Also, he's got a really fucked up face.
And he has one big tooth.
But yes, he has a brown shirt. Yes.
Where's this yarmulke?
All right.
It's there. It's just hidden by the hair.
You know what's cool is that you guys didn't know that this image existed before, and it was awesome being here to experience your guys' introduction to Scooby-Doo as a man.
Oh my goodness, I didn't know that Scooby-Doo was actually a person. He had a terrible accident with a transmogrifier.
I was gonna say the horrible reveal that this is a prequel episode before he got turned into a dog, and he's been begging for help whole time. He just can't get it out.
Did you guys ever watch the show where there were teenagers, and so it's Scooby and Shaggy when like Scooby's a puppy and Shaggy's a teenager, and he has Scooby's dog house in the backyard that's actually like a mansion underground. Kind of like
Dexter's. Oh, that's a pup named Scooby-Doo, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that show is garbage.
I liked parts of it.
Just crush her dreams.
I was going to say rags with brutal reality there.
No, it's a dumb show. The show was dumb. And Fred, really? They made Fred into an idiot.
I'm sorry. Someone in the chat called him Scooby-Jew.
Oh no. Why would you say that?
Oh my God.
Scooby-Jew.
Oh my God.
Scooby-Jew.
Guys, Scooby-Jew 2, the master race.
Not even a parody of.
Oh no, we're gonna get a bunch of people doing the Scooby-Jew titles now.
Oh no!
Congratulations. Again.
Well, here I didn't
why
like
this Joker have this happen.
They made Fred an idiot, and they made Velma insanely smart, and she did everything because she's so smart, and she just is insufferable.
Wow, Rags and hates Fred's intelligent women.
They made Fred an idiot. Yeah, I do. That's why I fucked Thorn.
When I watched it.
Well.
I haven't seen it since it came out on Cartoon Network. Back in the day.
Remember when Cartoon Network... No. We're not going to get into a tangent. Count Chicken. So, let's go and let's talk
about... The last
about
thing we want to do is get onto a tangent.
I am Weasel.